Hello guys, and welcome to the fourth episode of the Architects3DP MEGA build.
A big size and industrial quality 3D printer that we are building step by step from scratch along this series here at Architects3DP.
In the last episode, I finished the assembly of the structure of the 3D printer provided by Synerges, one of our sponsors for this huge project that together with you, our Patreon supporters, are making this crazy build possible. Today I'm going to unbox all the necessary components for motion dynamics that we're going to use for the movement in every axis of the 3D printer. All these components have been provided by the main sponsor of this project, Damen CNC, that, trust me, has made a huge sponsoring, providing more than 1,000 euros in components. Damen CNC was founded in the Netherlands by Kevin Damen, who started building CNC machines back in 2003-2004 as a hobby, beside his studies of aerospace engineering. He wasn't able to get the parts because he wasn't taken seriously, so he had to order components like shaft couplers in bigger quantities. That's how he decided to sell the other parts in the webshop, founding Damen CNC in 2005. At this point, they don't build or make any machine since the webshop sales exploded, but the company assists other builders with their parts from stock, as well as technical know-how. Damen CNC is not the cheapest company, since they made the decision to only sell good quality components. And also, they are one of the few companies that actually have a great knowledge of what they do.
They actually guided me to choose the right components for the Architects3DP MEGA, by the way.
And I actually had a great experience with their technical support via email. Finally, as to why you should choose Damen CNC over other companies, they have over 5,000 high-quality parts in their catalog. They really have physical stock.
Every item in stock in their website is in stock in their warehouse. They have 3D models of most of the parts online in a step 214 format to make it easy for engineers and hobbyists like me to develop our projects.
Actually, this has been a key point for the design.
Since I'd modeled in 3D all the 3D printed parts, starting from the 3D blocks of the components that I got from their website, damencnc.com.
Finally, the last point is, as I said before, that at Damen CNC they really have knowledge of what they sell, and they can help you make your project successful. They give free advice per email, as well as on-site where hired. I'm gonna let you down in the description the link to their website, damencnc.com, as well as the bill of materials with the links of each of the components I use for the build. Now that you know more about our great sponsor, I'm gonna jump to the unboxing of the great quality components they provided.
Alright, so as you can see, all the components come inside this huge and heavy box that I'm going to open right now.
But before starting, be sure to click here in the subscribe button and to ring that bell to be notified when new cool stuff is uploaded. If you do it, you will help me creating new content and growing the channel to reach more special viewers like you.
Alright guys, so finally here, I'm gonna cut the tape and open the box. As you can see, it's full of protective foam to make sure none of the components get damaged in the shipping.
So I'm going to put all of it away, and I'm going to start revealing the components we got from Damen CNC.
The first we find is this transparent plastic bag that has some components inside. The first one is this IEC inlet filter that will bring all the necessary power from the network with safety. Next, we find this great quality power switch, that as you can see is protected from dust and so on. Actually, we got three of them to control not only the power of the electronics, but also possible lighting or cooling solutions. Next, in this box we find what is tagged as LMT20UU. And as you can see, it's a huge linear ball bearing made for a 20mm calibrated rod. If you are used to deal with the LM8UU used in the i3 style 3D printer as I do, you'll get impressed by how heavy and well built these ball bearings are. Actually, I got four of them. One for each of the four corners of the print bed. In the next box, we have two components that are tagged as shaft 20, two pieces. With this, we will attach one of the ends of the 20mm rods of the print bed. We got two boxes of two shafts, what makes a total of four. Next, we have this transparent plastic bag, actually two of them, that contain these great flange bearings to host the 12mm threaded rods of the Z-axis. As you can see, they are very strong and heavy, what will keep our printer nice and robust. Next components are these two 6301ZZ groove ball bearings that will host the other end of the 12mm threaded rods. One more time, these components look out of scale if you are used to deal with the components of a Prusa i3 style 3D printer. Next, we'll find this plastic bag with four trapezoidal nuts. in charge of moving the print bed up and down, transferring the movement from the 12mm threaded rods. We'll mount two of them on each rod to eliminate backlash in the Z-axis. For the next component, we have not one, or two, or three, but four genuine HIWIN H15C blocks. As you can see, they come very well protected and lubricated, and we'll use two of them for the Y-axis, and one for each of the two independent extruders of the Architects3DP MEGA. Next, we find this bigger box that is surprisingly heavy, and if we have a look inside, we can see that it contains not less than 8 NEMA 17 stepper motors. We'll use two of them for the Z-axis, two for the Y-axis, two for each independent X-axis, and two for the two extruders.
Now I'm gonna jump already to the long packages, where we'll find, I guess, all the profiles. I got all of them with the perfect length, since they were precision cut beforehand by Damen CNC. This is a very handy service that you don't have to forget, because imagine if you had to cut these heavy profiles by hand, if you don't have the proper machines as I do. It would be crazy.
So first, I'm gonna show you these four profiles I talked about before. As you can see, all of them come very protected and lubricated. And once we remove all the protections, here we have one of them. As you can see, it has been precision cut to 700mm, and all the sharp edges of the cut have been chamfered from Damen CNC, what is a good signal of their good quality work. Next, we have a package with the two 12mm trapezoidal lead screws, with a length, one more time, of 700mm. As you can see, they are high quality, and again, the chamfering the precision cut by Damen CNC. I'm going to screw the nut to see if it fits. And as you can see, it does perfectly.
Well, we're getting to the end of this unboxing, with only two more packages left that I guess will be the genuine HIWIN drill waste.
In this first package, we find two profiles. I'm gonna open it real quick, and as you can see, here we have one of these amazing HIWIN railways. These two have a length of 660mm. And are the ones for the Y-axis of the printer. As you can see, they have the mounting holes from the top to the bottom, since we're gonna mount them on top of the frame of the printer, screwed to the item 40x40 aluminum profiles. As you can see, the green caps for the bolt holes are of course included with the profiles. And last but not least, we're gonna go for the last profile, that I'm gonna show you from the side real quick. And as you can see, it's the 1110mm HIWIN railway that is gonna form the X-axis.
As you may remember from the last episode,
I originally planned to use the railway itself to build the X-axis, but since it's a very long distance and the extruders are quite heavy, I finally decided to mount it on the item 40x40mm Tisload aluminum profile, what will keep it nice and rigid. That's why I got this profile with the mounting holes on the back, but that's not a problem, since we're gonna drill the holes in the aluminum profile and we'll screw them in place from the back without any issues.
Alright guys, so at this point, we have reached the end of this episode, where we have made the unboxing of all the motion dynamic components for the Architects3DP MEGA. I'm gonna release very soon a few more videos like this, where I'm gonna make the unboxing of the electronics and other components that will allow us to continue with the build. Remember guys that as always, you will find the links for the bill of materials, STL files, tools, and sponsors down in the description. If you have any question or suggestion about this Architects3DP MEGA, please let me know in the comment section. I will love to answer to all of your comments and get any positive idea that could change the design of the Architects3DP MEGA to make it better. There are still some components that could be sponsored for this build, such as the heated bed heating pads, the aluminium plate, the printing surface, or plexiglass panels for the enclosure. If you are a company or you want to be part of this project as well, just let me know through my email, architects3dp@gmail.com. Finally, I just wanted to ask you to subscribe to Architects3DP if you still haven't, hit the like button, leave a comment, and share this video so more people will be able to enjoy with this project. And as always, a special shout out to our Patreon supporters for making this channel possible. If you want to join them and support the channel as well, you can do it navigating to patreon.com/architects3dp, clicking here in the top right corner, or in the link in the description. Remember that becoming a Patreon, you will get access to all the necessary components for this project, as well as all the past projects in the channel, and much more rewards that you can check in our Patreon page. Okay guys, so as always, see you in the next video!